trying to get in, but it popped away from my.
I just let him in. It was.
Oh, okay. Popped away from my screen there.
Yep. So we're at 151 days without a recordable injury. And then today we're going to talk about the flu season and COVID-19. So influenza, facts, good to know about cold versus flu. So symptoms onset is gradually for colds and it's abrupt for flu. Fever is rare for cold and usual for the flu. Aches is slightly unusual for flu, and then the chills is uncommon, and for the flu, it's fairly common. So it's important that we know the signs, so we're watching out. The flu is contagious even before symptoms start. The flu can develop suddenly without warning. That's why it's important to know the signs. And recovery period is roughly 7 days for the flu. Do your part, practice good hand hygiene. If you have symptoms like fever or cough, avoid close contact and stay home. CDC is still pushing mask up, lather up, and sleeve up. And postpone social gatherings and make it virtual or pick up the phone. And then ways to prevent the cold and flu is eat lots of fruits and veggies, exercise, boost immune functions, get plenty of sleep and rest, take multivitamins, keep your hands away from your face, take a vitamin C and D supplement, and wear a mask when in large areas when lots of people. We did learn some things last year that we didn't have a really big flu season, and that's because we were home or we were being very cautious who we were around if we had symptoms of being sick. But we are trying to make sure that people are aware that wearing a mask is not like you got cooties or anything, but just taking that extra precaution. And this morning, if you are interested in the flu clinic, I'm there from 7 to 11, and I will be over in the surveyor's garage. Look for the blue tent, and please show up with a mask and have your paperwork filled out.
Paperwork is on Scott Burns' desk in this building?
Correct, or it's outside of Ronnie's office on the bulletin board, or it's in the email attached that I sent out to everybody, or I have some out here on the side of the safety department podium.
Perfect. Nice. So on, I think, about your second slide, you had the list of symptoms, and I was surprised to see that it said for the flu that it was unusual to have fatigue and weakness.
Right. Yeah, this is from the CDC, so I wanted to put that there so people understood what the symptoms were to be looking for, because it's changed from year to year.
Oh. That's why. Okay. All right. Okay. Thanks, Alberta.
You're welcome.
I'll take over here and finish up on the announcements and project of the week. Just have to track down my right window. See if this does it. Oh, yes. Okay. I'm here. Do you guys see it?
It's not quite up here yet.
Okay.
Black screen.
All right, well, that's a good sign.
I have it here.
There we go. Okay. So announcements, congratulations to Brian Cota this week. He's our newest operating foreman. And the flu clinic, as Alberta said, is immediately following this meeting at the surveyor shop. And also we still have a link to the pet food warehouse discount app. And we're excited to announce that the Breast Cancer Awareness Month fundraising effort has resulted in so far $4,300 in money raised for the American Cancer Society. And there's our two key people for moving this project along. And thank you very much for both of you, both Sarah and Alberta, for doing this. I think it's a great thing. It shows up too, doesn't it? It's a real team type of thing, and I left the photos here for the.
Can you guys
the month, because it is Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
Perfect.
Did you have something to say, Ben?
Yeah, there was a lag in the photos.
Oh.
But now I see the one.
It was stuck on the top screen for some reason. Maybe it's just slow today.
Yeah, maybe my connection may be slow. So lots of pink out there.
Yeah.
I've left again the ECI primary care wellness program link here, so check it out. And the weather today is supposed to be a little bit better than yesterday's, which is great. I think it'll be cooler though, and it's going to remain cooler for a while now. Oh, and I think I was supposed to announce, and I forgot to put in the announcements, that because of the weather changes, we need to start treating fuel. So fuel treatment, especially if you're not burning fuel, you know, heavy fuel consumption in a piece of equipment. You know, if you're going through a tank a day right now, it's not a big deal because the temperature is not bad. But as soon as it gets cold, it'll be a problem. So if you got equipment that sits around with a tank of fuel that doesn't get fueled except for every couple of weeks or something, make sure you get it done right away. Let's see. I think missed a number there on the Congratulations Vermont. 89.3% or something like that. So we're closing in that 90% vaccinated in Vermont. And this week we're presenting for the project of the week, the Champlain Housing Trust, the 40th and Allen in Spring Street projects. We're contracted with J.A. Morrissey for improvements to several properties. Most of them, I think, were newly acquired by the Champlain Housing Trust. The property is located on Spring Street in Winooski and 40th and Allen in Colchester. The two larger apartment buildings at 309 and 397 40th and Allen Avenue in the fort required extensive reconstruction of the concrete porch slab. It was all an elevated slab with beams and stairs that had to get replaced or repaired. The work involved shoring of the porch deck and its roof, complete demolition of the stairs, surgical demolition of deck and beams, complex forming and pouring sequencing. The work also included a dumpster pad and gravel, or grading and paving, at the parking area behind one of the buildings. The work at 53 to 65 Spring Street, East Spring Street, involved reconstruction of the north end of number 65 with an extension of the basement. Project also included regrading and paving of the parking area and some new concrete sidewalk. And just a little interesting fact I saw here. I didn't know too much about the Champlain Housing Trust, but I looked them up. And this is from Wikipedia that says that the Champlain Housing Trust is a membership-based nonprofit, is a non-governmental organization, and it creates and preserves affordable housing in Northwest Vermont. And the report was that as of 2019, the Champlain Housing Trust was the largest land trust in the United States. So that's pretty impressive. So this was the engineer's drawing. Zoom this in a little bit. There we go. For 309 Ethan Allen. See the owner there. It's some sort of combined effort with this company Evernorth and Champlain Housing Trust. And our client is a construction manager, J.A. Morrissey. And there's architect and structural guys, Richard Doherty. We know Richard, and Krebs and Lansing, of course, is civil consultant. I'm sure that some of you recognize these buildings out on the main street through the 40th and Allen that faces Route 15. They are kind of old. They're, I think, around the turn of the 20th century, so early 1900s, maybe earlier. And there was severe deterioration of some of the porch concrete. Here you can see one of the columns and some of the connection details are just kind of all rotted out. So of course, lots of demo, heavy demo on some of it. There's the stairs especially all got totally removed. Then there was a lot of surgical demolition of the rest of it. And you see here, we're putting it back together and forming. You see some of the shoring, they're shoring underneath, they're shoring of the roof. You can see some of the beam replacement on the front of the porch slab and pouring of the stairs, which were pretty complex. Fairly wide set of stairs suspended. There's a detail from the drawings. And then there's the result. Looks pretty nice. Nicely cut edge. Now it looks great on the formed edge. Looks good there.
Yeah.
And whoops. For some reason, my computer went blank. Are you guys still there?
We see it.
You do? Okay. I can't see anything.
We're looking at the head-on view of the stairs now.
Huh. Okay. I don't know why. For some reason, I'm not seeing anything. But I'm going to try scroll down. You can tell me what you're seeing.
Yeah, just keep scrolling down. It worked there for a second.
Okay.
Yeah, just keep going. A little bit another more. Picture. Yeah, there's Troy underneath. There was a lot of work underneath.
Okay.
This is the suspended deck porch. Troy's been a.
Yeah, you can see underneath some of the on the Troy picture. You see some of the how nice it looks under all the repair underneath, and there was a lot of. I assume there was a lot of chipping on the laying on your back or some of the guys on their back.
Yeah. Yep.
Tell me when I can stop scrolling.
Just keep going down a little bit more. You're halfway to the next picture. A little more. There you go. That's the work that we did out back. That Rob Smith and Joe Prowse and team did. Kind of a extended parking lot.
Right. Yep.
That was completed a couple weeks ago, maybe about a month ago. But some fence installation and kind of a whole reconstruction of the parking lot.
Okay.
And you can scroll down to, I think you have a set of plans next.
Trying to watch it on my other screen now, my other computer. But it doesn't seem to be moving. Is it moving there?
No, stop. I'll try to pull mine up here.
Yeah, okay, if you can do it. That'll be helpful. And then, you know, the project too, in the last couple images are actually at the Spring Street, East Spring Street site.
Okay, let me put mine up here. Guys, see that okay?
Yep. There we go.
Yeah, so there's a little detail drawing. Just kind of where our work areas are in the project.
That's after Jay Morrissey is building doing some of the stick build above the slab in the or not really a slab, it's a basement compartment there. There is a slab for like a wheelchair ramp in the back.
Gotcha.
You can see our new concrete in the pavement.
Yep. Nice. I remember this job.
Yep. This is the photo archive. That was very pretty much that's 40th and Allen or Ethan Allen Avenue. I think it's one of the buildings we're not working on right there. That's I do think that might be one that was purchased by the housing trust. That's at the very end towards the Burlington side of the that avenue. That was 2017 doing sidewalk reconstruction. That was all that old blue stone slate type sidewalk that got replaced with reinforced concrete.
I think that's Kenny King working, raking, doing that rake. And I think Adam Piper and team was doing that project at that point in time.
Yep. Good. Okay. Thanks for taking over there, Matt.
Yeah, no problem. A little sorry for the technical difficulties today. We'll have that from time to time, but everybody be safe today. If you're up for it, let's go get some flu shots.
Yep.
We'll see. Sounds good. Have a safe day, everybody.
Thanks. See ya.
Well, I'm not the only one that had a technical difficulty.
Stop recording.